In the form editor, you have the rectangle with the hello text in the center of it. If you can't find the form editor, you can enable it by selecting View, Views, and Form Editor. Let's start by deleting the text component. Next, select the rectangle and change its fill color. I change it to white. This area is the background for our application as a whole. Next, select a rectangle from the component list and drag it into the form editor area. This will be the input area of our application, so let's make it a bit bigger. In the navigator view, you can see that it is a child of the larger rectangle. Give the rectangle a new ID. I'll call it the main view rectangle. Notice that the ID name needs to begin with a lowercase letter. In the properties, you can change the colors of the rectangle. Increasing the radius, you will get rounded edges. Now, we'll add an image placeholder inside the rectangle we just created. Drag the image component inside the main view rectangle. In the navigator, you can see that it becomes a child of the main view rectangle. In the properties layout tab, select Fill Parent Component, which is the button at the center of the anchors row. This selection makes the image as big as its parent. Here, we can also set the margins if we want to give it some space around the edges. I set 20 pixels for each. Now you can see that the image placeholder is a bit smaller than the rectangular. What we just did is called anchoring. Anchoring means that the component stays in the same place in relation to the parent depending on what you have selected as anchor lines. You can anchor the component in relation to top, bottom, left, right, or center it horizontally or vertically. You can also fill the parent component entirely. If we would now change the size of the main view rectangle, the image item would change size accordingly. In our case, it would always fill the parent rectangle with 20 pixel margins. Let's also anchor the main view rectangle to its parent. Select main view rectangle and in the layout tab select anchor component vertically. Next, select anchor component to the left. Design Studio will automatically set the margin as the current pixel number. I'll change it to 100. Now we have anchored the main view rectangle vertically and in relation to the parent rectangle's left edge. The image placeholder inside the main view rectangle has followed its parent. Next, we will transform the main view rectangle into a component so that we can give it different states. Go to the navigator view and right-click on top of the main view rectangle. Select Move Component into Separate File. A pop-up window appears. The component now has a name called My Main View Rectangle, and it will create a new UI.qml file. We can leave the property assignments unchecked and click OK. You can see that in the navigator, the main view rectangle's icon has changed. In the projects list, a separate UI.qml file has appeared. When we double-click on it, it only shows the image inside the main view rectangle, which is the parent-child component we just created. In screen 01, the component is still in its place. You can also see the component under My Components, and you could use it multiple times without the need to create it again every time. Now we have created our first component in our UI. In the next video, we will give it different states.